All right, welcome to BKW Physics Today. We're going over a homework problem here that we some people were struggling with.
Sure.
It happens to be number 38 in the textbook on page 111. And what you were given is the following items. You were given that the velocity was 55 kilometers per hour. You were given that the time was 0.75 seconds. And you were asked to find the distance. Now, I'm going to have you, Lucas, read this problem out loud. So this is what I pulled out of the problem. How did they say it in the book? So go to page 111 for me. And read problem 38. Nice and loud.
A car is moving down a street at 55 kilometers an hour. A child suddenly runs into the street. If it takes the driver 0.75 seconds, react and apply the brakes, how many meters will the car have moved before it begins to slow down?
Okay, so you as new drivers, this is a super scary situation. You're driving down the road and some kid that's just not thinking or not paying attention runs out in front of you and you're like, oh my gosh, and you gotta get your foot to the brake. But you're a new driver and you happen to not be totally paying attention, so it takes you a little longer than normal. This is in the realistic range, by the way. Okay? This is a realistic range for somebody that's not really sharp at that moment. So in that time, how far forward does your car travel before you even touch the brake? That's what you're asking. So how do you go about doing this? Well, the first thing my brain's thinking is, well, we have an equation. Velocity is distance over time. And I'm sure it probably relates to that, because it's our only equation right now. But, we got a problem. Let's back up and look real quick at our units. These units aren't matching. What I mean by that is this says kilometers per hour, and that says seconds, and hours and seconds aren't matching. And when the units don't match, the first thing you got to do in physics is make your units match. So as a little aside, I'm going to take 55 kilometers per hour, and I'm going to make it meters per second. That way my units are where they should be. So here's how I'm going to do it. The kilometers are on the top, so to cancel them out, I'm going to put them on the bottom. And I want to get to meters. So I have to ask myself the important question, how many meters are there in a kilometer? Answer? 1,000. Okay? Now, if you're confused with that, you can go to the prefixes on your reference table, front page, and you can see that there are 1,000 meters in 1 kilometer. That's effectively taking care of the kilometers, left us with the meters. We're doing good, but let's switch over the hours to seconds. So the hours are on the bottom, therefore they have to be canceled to the top. And I'm looking for seconds. So how many seconds are there in an hour? Yeah, there's 3,600 seconds. And the way you arrive at that is you say, okay, there's 60 seconds in a minute, 60 minutes in an hour, times those together, you got 3,600 seconds in an hour. And now I've effectively canceled the hours. I'm left with meters and seconds. At this point, I multiply this by this, divide by that, and through the magic of a handy-dandy calculator, you get 15.3 meters per second. That's the number I want to use for velocity because now my units are going to match and they're set up correctly. All right, so let's move forward. I got this now because I just took some time to find it. I was given this and I'm really looking for this. So as I've been trying to help you practice, when you have a physics equation, the first thing you want to do is rearrange the equation. And this is a pretty easy equation to rearrange. So I'm going to take and multiply by t by both sides, and I'm going to get velocity times time is the distance. What's the next step according to looking on both ends of the room? We're going to plug in our numbers with the units. So in this case, we have 15.3 meters per second, and we got a time of 0.75 seconds. I multiply those two things together, and actually my calculator will tell me 11.45 meters, and some of your hit the brakes, the SIGs don't work. So how many SIGs did my original Gibbons have?
Two.
So my answer has to have
two.
So I need to look to here, look to the right, that's a 11 meters of distance. So while you are going, oh no, and moving your foot to the brake, you cover 11 meters, which is, by the way, about the length of this room. It's kind of long distance, okay? I don't know if the kid makes it or not, but it makes me scared, okay? So for today, that's it, physics.